Everyone has their differences. No one is the same. We all have different origin stories that bring us to who we are today. I thoroughly believe that everyone has a unique beginning and that no one has the same start in life. I think that's what makes us all special. We're all different and not the same. For some, these differences are clear and obvious to see. For others, these differences aren't so clear and are hard to see. Some are hidden. Some never see light. And in this story, I want to shed a little light on a rare beginning to make it easier for others to see. My name is Peter Cherick, and I was born with a brachial plexus injury. The brachial plexus is the network of nerves that send signals from your spinal cord to your shoulder, arm, and hand. A brachial plexus injury occurs when these nerves are stretched, compressed, or in the most serious cases, ripped apart or torn away from the spinal cord. Growing up, I never realized that what I was dealing with was out of the ordinary. I figured everyone was like me. Once I realized I was different, I had so many questions, you know, as a normal person would. So I decided to talk to the two people that have been there for me since day one.
When we found out that you had brachial plexus, we didn't know what it was. The doctor himself really couldn't explain it to us, except for like a one sentence description.
Approached us with an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper with one paragraph on it stating that you had a brachial plexus injury. That was it.
There was very little information out there, and the internet was, for us, was just starting as far as what we could start to research.
We didn't have cable or much of anything at the time, but we had over-the-air TV. Channel 12, there was a reporter, Jerry Taft. He blurted out, well, there's a birth injury becoming more prevalent. It's called brachial plexus injury. And they displayed a phone number and racing to find something to write it down and everything.
We did some more research and I found a newsletter which was put out for parents of children with brachial plexus injuries.
From what I can understand or remember, there was one doctor, at least in the United States, and the other place that he worked was Milwaukee Children's Hospital.
We then made an appointment to take you in and have you checked out, and from there is when the real help began for you. We had been doing what they call range of motion exercises to keep your arm limber so atrophy would not set in.
The surgery was a complete success considering the scope of the injury. Because you've done everything. You've climbed rock walls, you've done percussion.
Scouts was a big thing. I think you learned archery, which took you how many summers to complete that badge. But you were determined, and it was a hard thing to do, but you did it.
The fear of no friends was blown out of the water with you being a social butterfly and now a party animal.
Having older siblings was a benefit to you and to us as parents because you would go ahead and try to do what they were doing. So we weren't holding you back. We were trying to encourage you to do more with your left arm and not like have you baby it. Being a normal kid, you just did whatever you felt you could do, like climbing on a chair and other things that a 2 or 3 year old would do.
I guess for me as a parent or any parent, you don't want your child to have to go through that. And I know I found out later that you probably were in some extreme pain that we didn't know about when you were little. But you want to make it right and you want to make it easy, but it was a struggle not knowing the outcome for you. So I guess we did what we felt was right to get you the help you needed and hope that you could live a normal life like anyone else, even with that limitation. I think that especially if a child is born with it, has the injury at birth, that earlier the better as far as prevention. I know brachial plexus injuries can also happen to adults in accidents and whatnot, but I think that it really becomes the parent's job
to be the advocate for that child, and but also to really put their whole heart into it.
Research, reach out, search out, find people that had this and talk about it. It's the best thing. Again, ours was a scope of luck.
I guess just don't give up. Just keep trying. Try different things. Don't just feel like one thing didn't work and that's it and they're done. And you need to just keep trying. I mean, I look at it that this is your child and you have one chance to try and make this better for them and better life, because you don't want them to have to deal with this the rest of their life. They will, but it won't have to be to that extreme. So, and it just makes for a better quality of life for them. So I guess as a parent, you just do that. That's what you do. That's why you've had children. You're gonna take care of them.